while, we're going to be rising up to pray. We're going to be praying the prayer of thanksgiving. Hallelujah. Amen. Malachi chapter 2. I'll read from verse 1 to 2. We're going to be rising up to pray a prayer of thanksgiving. I'm going to do a little bit of charge. Thank you. I'm going to be a little bit of a charge, and then we'll move into maybe two or three things the Lord wants us to hear tonight. He said, and now, O ye priests, this commandment is for you. If you will not hear, and if you will not take it to heart, to give glory unto my name, says the Lord of hosts, I will send a curse upon you. I will curse your blessings. Yea, I have cursed them already, because you did not lay it to heart. Ingratitude attracts a curse. I've seen people who have made good money before, and they become proud in the process, and they come down. Nothing brings a man and a woman down like ingratitude. There is nothing we ever have that we can ever cause success that it is in energy of our flesh to achieve it. The life we live is given to us by God. When God will give us this life, he never needed our permission. The day God will take it, he won't need your permission. God has given us a seed called the life. And we can trade with life to bring about tremendous change, tremendous success. But let me tell you and understand this, and let me give you this guarantee. If you will not lay it to heart to return the glory to God for every blessing and everything you receive, you are attracting a curse. The book of Malachi told us, he said, this commandment is for you, O ye priests. If you will not lay it to heart to return the glory to my name, he said, I will curse your blessing. Meaning, there are every blessing remain uncursable when we are grateful to God. Every blessing will remain uncursable when we are grateful to God. Every blessing will attract a curse. If we take pride, there are many persons who said, it is my brain that gave me first class. Who gave you the brain? Who gave you the life for you to be able to put yourself together to even pass exam? I was one time in Delta State. I visited an hospital I will never forget in a hurry. In those days, I used to have a program where I visit hospital to hospital. And when we come into the hospital and then we see people on the bed, we pray for them. The people who can support, will support. And in those days, we don't go to the hospital to empty-handed. Sometimes we go with toiletries and all of that we used to go with. As I visited this place in Oroquel, well, I will never forget. We entered the hospital and then I saw a man. He was covered with mosquito net. And when we moved close, flies were around the mosquito net. So I know there must be something smelling or decaying inside the mosquito net. The story of this man was that one day he was riding his bike. As he was going, a lorry from the front, which was actually a truck in the front that was carrying inflammables, maybe like petrol or something. Something happened and then this truck actually fell down and the fuel began to leak. And then the fuel actually was traveling from far distance. And if you are very good in driving, you know what I'm talking about? That if you're actually driving and then you see fuel on the road in that kind of number, if you apply brake, your tire might not pick anymore. So when he saw that it was fuel on his back, he wanted to apply brake. As he wanted to do that, he fell down. The moment he came on the ground, that was when the fuel caught fire. The fire caught up with him, burnt up his bike, and burnt the man. But he was alive. He didn't die. They rushed him to the hospital. When they rushed him to the hospital, the whole body was peeled off. The man was there naked. And they have to use a mosquito net to cover him. The blessing, the bike was a blessing. How many of you agree with me? The life that man had, that money to actually travel was a blessing. How many of you agree with me? But on his road, something happened. Beloved, every blessing you are not grateful for attracts a curse. This commandment is for you, O ye priest. If you will not lay to heart to return the glory to my name, said the Lord. He said, I will curse your blessing. He said, yea, I've cursed them already. The Bible said, by strength shall no man prevail. Now let me tell you this. Gratitude is the cure for pride. Gratitude is the cure for waste. Nothing help you to kill your pride easily like gratitude. People that are proud find it difficult to say sorry. People that are proud find it difficult to say thank you. I've seen many people who shut the door of blessing against themselves all just because of one thing. Because of ingratitude. Every man can bend down where they kneel. But how many men can bend down when they are sufficient? When you are in need, you can even prostrate for somebody that is younger than you. When you are in need, you can go to an office. In the office, and you met somebody who is quite younger than you, you forget your age. At that time, you will still tender your application if they will consider you. And if they consider you, you will say yes, sir, to that person. To that person, you feel you are older than. But how many people are grateful? How many people are humble when things are really working for them? Nothing destroys a man faster like pride. For every result you get, don't think it's a prayer. No, there are people who pray and yet they don't see things. Our prayer is just one day after I finished praying in the middle of the night, something happened this month. So I was driving somewhere and I don't know. I was just driving up the church. I don't know where I was going. I can't remember now. And then it came to me that, young man, you pray all through the night. There's some few things you are supposed to see during the day, but somehow, maybe you have not seen. Something came to me and I believed it was God speaking to me. He said, praying is just fulfillment, that you are ready for what you are looking for. Prayer does not guarantee that you get what you are looking for. Many of us have prayed, and yet you don't get results. The reason why God will not answer some people's prayer, or God will actually keep some people's prayer, is simply because when they have it, they are proud. They are never even grateful to God. Neither would they be grateful to the channel that brought it. It's a culture in my house that when they cook, even the little children who can say thank you, say thank you. When they bring food for me, I say thank you. Despite the fact that God helped me to bring the money. If she choose not to cook, what will happen? There's no way they ever pay my salary, I don't say thank you. Because it's in the capacity of that person to sit on it and nothing will happen. You close door against yourself if you are not grateful. You attract a curse over your blessing when you are not grateful. There are many people who things has worked for a particular time. They just discover that the people who used to help them begin to turn against them. Don't think it's a witch fighting you. Check your gratitude level first. A man gave you a cup of water. You despise a man the day you were thirsty. That man will keep his cup inside the store. That the day you are genuinely hungry, water won't even reach you. We need to learn the attitude of gratitude. If our blessings will be preserved, pride will be taken away from the equation of our results. Anything that we have ever achieved, that you ever see as something good, before you say, I'm the one that did it. And I, you see, I've seen people who sing well. They know how to sing. But they diminish with time. They go down with time. It is not singing that make a man, it is God. God is the lifter of the head of man. It's God that selects the people to lift. It's God that look at the CV of people to... God will never lift a proud person. It has never come to my mouth once. My church, I've never said it before. Ask anybody who's close to me. It is our church. With the understanding of God, the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost, I'm only a partaker of what God is doing. When God helped me to buy anything, in the little money God gave me to church, I give God thanks for it. I don't know the way to open my heart so that you understand what I'm talking about. If someone is my husband, he used to give me monthly allowance for 10,000. And then when he give you the money, you look, he said, it's not easy in the market. 10,000 cannot reach anything. And that's why 10,000 reduced to 5,000. And the man will come with a lot of excuses that things are not easy. It's not because there is a witchcraft. It's simply because you're ungrateful. Nothing causes your blessing and reduces you like ingratitude. God said, I have caused the blessing. He said, I have caused them already. I'm going to give us a little time. And please join me as a church. I beg you in the name of God. And please join me as a church. Let's give God thanks from the depth of our heart. The last healing experience service was the kind you have never seen before. The kind. Few testimony that has rolled in, you'll be amazed. The lot that people will share, you'll be grateful. Somebody says our strategy that is working is a lie. The people who pioneered those strategies, they are still old people. There are people who has actually been in the system for more than a year. How come they did not actually pioneer that strategy and it worked before? Somebody is saying it's because of the way maybe I play keyboard and the drum was sounding. No, sir. When God is out of your equation, you are just a mere noise. We are going to go before the Almighty God and thank Him from the depth of our heart. This is what we have come to thank Him for tonight. We have prayed. We have prayed for the church. We have prayed for the land. We are praying that God will take over the territory. That men and women in this territory will come under the lordship of Jesus. That's kingdom advancement prayer. That's the right prayer we should pray. When men and women are under the lordship of Jesus, men, women, and the children in this territory, Kubwaduse, the territory where our harvest field are represented. Can I tell you this? A lot of things you are looking for will come to us freely. Somebody is looking for a wife. Your wife is still trying to do some funny things in the night. And yet, he doesn't know Jesus yet. And that's why you are stranded. Somebody is saying, I'm praying for a husband. Your husband is in the beer parlor now, possibly, taking some good numbers of bottles. Until these people come to the lordship of the Christ, the agenda, the fulfillment of the prophecy over them might not come to pass. And that's why we must intercede for every territory where we are found. We have prayed, seeking first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all other things shall be added unto you. Thank God for that. But you know something? Let's not forget what the Lord did in the last healing experience service. Oh, don't forget. Let me tell you one thing. At a particular time, I saw breeze coming in. And I saw a few guys and the usher, they were running around just to close the windows. Immediately, I knew it was rain. And I closed my eyes right there, and I said, there will be no rain. And the Lord said, there will be no rain. I wasn't disturbed. I continued with what I was doing excitedly, rejoicingly. I know God cannot lie. It was when I stepped out, I began to see little drop. That rain truly wanted to fall. And the rain actually wanted to fall so heavy to the point that there was no star nor moon up there. I know the rain was stored up there. When we got to the house, then I told my wife, I said, we really need to give God thanks. We really need to. There are some things when you are not told, you will not know the depth. In the history of this church, when people attend the healing experience service, we have never had this number before. We are over 100 in the last meeting. We never had that. If you are clapping, glory to Jesus. You can clap. Thank you. We never, never had that kind of God. He said, but that's our level. When God does something new, be grateful. Don't take pride. You know the reason why money does not last in the people, in some people's hand? When they have money, that's when they do like this. The kind of chicken they have never eaten before, that's what they want to eat. He said, no, I want bread from Life Camp. How much is transport from here to Life Camp to go and eat bread? Are we together? No. It's Use bread. Those ones are for good people. You are not at the level yet. Use bread are for people that stay in Use. Kubwa bread, they already plan your own there. Can I hear you, man? If you journey to Use and then God help you, you can buy and come. Good. But not to carry yourself from here. You say, it's bread I want to. That's poverty per... No. That's poverty per mediocrity. The poverty that your village people are sitting on. How much bread? 600. How much is the transport? Money will never last in the hand of people who are not never grateful. Never. Never. I know it. Never. Never. Father, thank you. If you want God to sustain our results and God to not cause the blessing that we are saying, let's thank him. Somebody say, it's my salary, I used to buy this shirt. No. God send that money from heaven. You only pass through your salary to reach you. And when you are too boastful of your salary, that's why at the long run, the salary will not be enough. And the salary will eventually stop. They don't pay anybody salary for life. They will change the name. Even if you're a government worker, they change it to pension. Pay. Somebody earning 200,000 will not be earning 24,000. That is take. Don't die with thinking. Nobody has salary for life. So whatever God brings your way, the Bible said a man can receive nothing except to be given from above. We know all the people that came, the Lord draw them. God draw them. All the people that meant to be here who had meeting, glory to God. But the number of people that were in the last two turnaround experience, in the last healing experience service, that I know that did not come, they are more than 20. Yeah. And yet, our tenders never dropped. Rather, it increased. It increased. Somebody say, no. It's because God, help our man of God. This is a man of God, okay. Forget it. There's nothing around me. All the glory must be to God. Somebody say, as he prayed, God, heal somebody. Thank God you say, God, not me. I'm as ordinary as who you can ever think of. If you remove God away from my life, it is him that work in us, both to will and to do for his good pleasure. Yes, good pleasure. How many of you will rise up your feet tonight? And join me in holy singing. Just wave your hands and just begin to give him thanks. Say, Father, we thank you for the last healing experience service. Thank you for the multitude you gathered. Thank you for giving us a perfect weather. Thank you for salvation of souls. Thank you for healing to the oppressed. Thank you for everything.